Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. I am Jay. Today I'm going to show you how to paint some flower basket with a water jug, still life hot, using acrylic colors. For that I am using this 8.5x8.5 watercolor notebook, and I'm going to use Winsor & Newton acrylic colors. I already have my colors in the palette: white, cadmium yellow, raw amber, this one is burnt sienna, this is teal green, this one is yellow oak. This is just black and white. We may need some tissues or washcloth and some paint brushes. I think some big flat brushes and some medium flat brushes and few round brushes for finer details. Now let's start. I'm going to go for a big flat brush to paint the background. I wet my brush. Let's start with little bit black. Just a touch texture layer, just to wet the canvas, adding more black, adding on the corners. As I go inside, I will make it lighter. So now let's take some raw amber. Just a zigzag pattern. Now, let's go for a smaller flat brush. I'm taking white, the same zigzag pattern, this time little bit smaller one. Little bit of yellow. When I go to center, I add yellow. Again, white. Little more color. White. Same zigzag pattern, little bit smaller one. Little bit green. Now let's go for black. And I'm gonna paint the outline for the table. same amber brown, little bit of yellow. Now with yellow ochre, paint the table. Since I already painted the background with black, it's a little bit darker. Little more yellow. Just brighten up the outskirts so the table, under the table, will be a little bit darker. I'm adding more black. I'm adding more black all around the table so it will brighten up. Now wash your brush, wipe off the excess water. Now with white, I'm using the same flat brush, just paint the outline of the mug, just a little curvy mouth. Now let's go for a round brush. Using black, I'm gonna highlight the outline. And so I'm gonna draw some handle. The same way, I'm gonna use the amber brown, paint the outline. Little bit shade near the mouth. Let it dry and we can paint a little more later. Now let's paint the flower basket. For that I am going to use the same pointer brush. I am using the raw amber brown. Just outline of the basket. Now let's use the brown. I'm mixing it with the raw amber brown. Let's add some texture. same way on the outside, just a little bump. Let them dry and then we add more details. Now with the smaller flat brush, take a little bit black, add some shade. On the table, the shadow. Now with the same flat brush, I'm gonna use some green to paint the leaves. Just adding a little bit oat yellow, it gives that light leaf color, little bit texture on the leaves. Since the background is dark, we are going for light colors. Let it dry before painting the flowers. The same flat brush that we used before to paint the jug, I'm gonna add more white. Now with the round brush, add white to the handle. More white. I'm using black to give some shade. Blend it with white. This gives the 3D effect for the jug. Now let's add some more shade, like a shadow under the mouth of the jug. Now let's add little bit colors on the outside so it will pop up the white mark. I'm gonna add the same flat brush, same technique, like a zigzag, blend it with the background. add more yellowish background. Let it dry. Now let's add more details to the flower basket. I'm gonna take a pointer brush and with oak yellow add textures. Just one side. We already gave black for the other side, so go for the opposite side where the light falls. The outside also just a zigzag pattern for the basket. Now I'm going to go with white. Just add more light. Just until the edge of the basket, since the light won't fall down below. Now, the same way, add some white in the outline. Now with black, differentiate the inside of the basket from the outside. I'm gonna add an outer line for the mouth of the basket. Now the same way, I'm gonna add some yellow for the leaves, just outline. Now for the flowers, I'm gonna use some white. A little bit smaller dot. Since it's falling down, we are going like the flowers are falling down from the basket. And the bigger flowers here. like a cluster of flowers. Not so much on the back because it's falling down from the front. So go for a lot of flowers in the center. Now let's add a little more white in the handle. Don't paint on the black outline that we gave, just on the edge of it. Now a little bit black for the shadow. The same pointer brush, I'm gonna paint the stems. Take a little more black or dark brown. Add stems for the flowers. Now add a little more white flowers on the stem. Now let's use a flat brush. I'm gonna darken the background a little bit more so the colors will pop out. The same zigzag pattern. Now let's order white silky cloth just falling from the table. For the texture, I am gonna use some little bit black, the same shade in the background, just random blobs. Now with white and a random brightness, it will give the illusion that the cloth is folded here and there. Now let's add little designs to the cloths. Finally, let's add some white table edges. on the white, add some yellow. Little bit of dark brown. I'm gonna add little bit yellow here, like the table is showing there. The black, more black. Just a short niche. We can add more black, little more black. Just highlight the outline. There. Now for the other side. A little bit on the bottom. See, it will pop up the flowers better. We can add a shadow for the flowers, just under the block. Like the flower is in the front of the mug and its shadow falls on the mug. Add a little more white, just on the edge. Let's add another line of white. Now for the leaves, I'm gonna add a little bit green. And I'm gonna add more leaves this side on the top. And stems. Little bit yellow. Brown. Let's use the green one more time. Little bit whiter, like the flowers are on the top. You can add more textures if you want. I'm gonna add a little, I'm gonna make them a little bit darker so the the actual object that we highlight, it will be a little bit brighter. You can use black. I'm just putting a little blobs of colors. Let's make a little brighter in the bottom. So the attention will come here. Just blend it along with the black. Now that's it. Now it's done. I hope you like the painting. Try it yourself. Thank you for watching. See you next time. Bye.